Yeah, good morning friends. Today I would like to discuss the concept of machine learning. As a computer science student, I am aware of some basic knowledge of what are the prerequisites like a data mining subject. So what are the definition of data mining? Simple, to extract the knowledge or to extract hidden patterns. You know, simple, I'm not going to subject. Suppose what is called gold mining? You can mine the gold from the rocks. So you are searching for gold, not for rocks. You are searching for gold where? So suppose you are all rocks, gold somewhere. So you are mining for gold. That is called gold mining. The same is, this is the data. So what is the interesting pattern? That is called knowledge. You are extract the knowledge from the data. That is called data mining. So we'll discuss later the machine learning. So many definitions from the machine learning different authors, but I am interested to tell the most impact definitions. Simple, the field of study that gives the computer the able to learn without being explicitly programmed. That means computer is able to learn without being any programming. So the programmer, maybe the machine has to program previously, but the computer itself can take the decisions, right? Suppose simple, you can compare with like a human brain. Suppose in our childhood, so how can I say this is the pen object? Maybe someone has told me. That is the reason when I see my eye, this is the pen, then immediately my brain can tell it is a pen. Suppose when I see the first time this object, I don't know what it is. The same as in your childhood, suppose any animal, suppose any four legs are there, maybe you can say it is an animal. So whenever you see that type of object, you can say that it is an animal. Or maybe your primary teacher, like a bat, a cat. So how will you identify that object? That means your brain is trained. Your brain is trained. When you see the later after 1 month or 2 months or maybe after 1 year, when you see that object, immediately your brain can tell, so that is the object is a maybe cat or dog or maybe cow, and differentiate. How? Your computer, like your brain is trained. The same as the machine learning, the machine is trained, itself can identify without being explicitly programmed. That is, you know, that means your mother or father are always not trained, even in your childhood, your mother trained. So what are these objects? Are your primary teacher trained? This is the man, this is the cat, this is the bat, this is the fish. But when you are coming to the adulthood, no one is trained. You can say this is the object, you can differentiate. That is the mission is able to learn without being explicitly programmed. The most famous definition given by the Tom Mitchell, that is a prescribed textbook, very good textbook. What the definition is, a computer program is said to learn from the experience E with respect to the class of task T and performance measure P. Here the mission trained from the experience. The mission is experience on any data set. On any data, suppose you can number of application, like suppose weather forecasting. So the mission from the experience, how the mission is experience, suppose from your experiences as a teacher, from your experiences, or maybe a doctor, from your experiences, you have some some ability is improved. The same, the computer learn from the experience with respect to some class of task T. What are the different types of class of tasks? Like the tasks are maybe classification, maybe clustering. So you can classify different groups. This is the group of objects are A, this is the group of objects are B, or maybe these are objects are good, their objects are bad. Right? So different types of tasks. And performance measure P. Performance means accuracy. Accuracy. Simple. I am not going to the subject. Simple example. When you are going to an astrologist, suppose your astrologist prediction, maybe next year and maybe you are go, some good things happen. Maybe next year, 2024. in the 2024, really you can achieve that. So what that means, your astrologist prediction may be 100% accuracy. Maybe other astrologist is also, some you are choosing 3-4 astrologists. One astrologist maybe is a different prediction. So the prediction is only maybe 90%. Some other astrologist maybe 85%. Obviously, you trusted only 100% accuracy because it will happen. So what he's told, it will happen in the 2024. So that's the same. The mission is an experience with respect to some task of T and performance measure T. This is the metrics like accuracy, precision, recall, SN score. So we'll discuss later. If it is performance task in T as measured by T, improves with experience E. That is what I am telling. So from the experience, the data, the mission, experience in the historical data, from the historical data, it can predict the future data. That is actually the machine learning task, prediction. It can predict the future data. So how it improves performance, so accuracy, maybe first time, maybe 95% accuracy, then 98%, maybe 100%, because number of times the mission tried. Right? So these are basic, these are the most, so many definitions, not only these two only, many definitions of the machine learning. Yeah, from the machine learning, so different types of learning method techniques are there. One is supervised learning, unsupervised learning, semi-supervised learning, reinforcement learning. They are the four learning techniques are classified from the machine learning. The machine learning techniques are classified into four types. One is the supervised learning, unsupervised learning, semi-supervised learning, reinforcement learning. So first, discuss what is called supervised learning. Wait a second. Definition. A machine is said to be learning from the past experience, data experience with respect to some class of task. Its performance in given task improve with the experience. Same what I told the previous. Yeah. These are the four types of learning. Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, semi-supervised learning, reinforcement learning. Some algorithms under supervised, some algorithms are classified unsupervised, some algorithms semi-supervised, some algorithms are under reinforcement learning techniques. So first, discuss what is called supervised learning. Yeah, supervised learning, it is a labeled learning technique. That means simple. In our class, suppose in your class, maybe 60 students are there. The 60 students, maybe already 40 students are good, 20 students are, maybe they are under good, they are maybe bad students. Or maybe any product category, suppose 100 items are there, maybe 60 are good products, 40 are bad products. Like a from the product reviews, maybe what is called like Amazon or Flipkart, maybe e-commerce based on the product reviews. These 60 students are good, 40. Maybe the student data, 40 students are good, 20 students are bad. Suppose any new student is there, it's a new object, any new product. So you have to find it is under good category or it is under bad category. Suppose your product, maybe student, new student is joined, he is a good student or bad student. What you call, maybe here the good or bad, in maybe in academic aspect. Suppose simple, they are CGPA above 7.5 CGPA, maybe these are maybe less than 5 CGPA or maybe 6 CGPA. So any new student is joined, first I am asked a question, what your CGPA? Sir, my CGPA is 7.6, obviously it is under category. Suppose here 40 plus 1 under good category. Suppose someone is my CGPA is 5.8, maybe not bad, average. So it is both based on the product review. So because here what I am telling, what I am intention is, it is already classified. These are the good or these are the bad. They are good customer, they are good, excellent customer, good customers, bad customer. So labeled classification, these are the labels are there. Labels are there. So simply, when a new object is there, you can identify this is under this label, under this label. Right? The definition, supervise a type of machine learning in which machines are trained using well-labeled training data and the basis of data machine can predict the output. The labeled data means some input data is already tagged with the correct output. So that's what I am told you. So these are all under good labeled. These are all under that. Suppose one more example, maybe you are still any confusion. Suppose weather forecasting. Suppose the weather, different types of label, maybe tomorrow what is the weather, maybe sunny, maybe rainy, or maybe windy, or maybe cold. These are all labeled. You can predict what the tomorrow temperature, either sunny and rainy or one. Sunny means there is some measure is there, maybe under 40 to 50 degrees centigrade. Maybe rainy, maybe 20 to 20, maybe 28 to 30. Maybe windy, so based on the wind speed. Or maybe cold, maybe basic, maybe under some range of temperature, this is the label. So in the future data, the machine is already trained on these four labels. Under sunny, under rainy, under windy, under cold, the machine is already trained. So when the machine is trained, any new data is fed in the future. Maybe tomorrow temperature, maybe the machine predict 45 degrees centigrade. Whether it is under sunny or rainy or windy or cold. So the machine is trained already. The 40 to 48, it is under sunny label. Maybe rainy is maybe 25 to 30. Or maybe, sorry, 30 to 40, maybe some rain is there. And windy, maybe wind speed. Maybe cold is 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. So tomorrow, temperature 45 degrees centigrade. Your machine predicted. The machine obviously it is under sunny. Your mission prediction that tomorrow temperature or maybe next month or maybe January 2024, 11, what is the temperature? The temperature value prediction is maybe 28 degrees centigrade. So it is under cold label. It is under cold label because the mission is already trained. The mission learning, the missions are trained using well-labeled training data. It's a the mission trained on the labeled data. Right? Suppose if it is unlabeled data, it is called a unsupervised learning. When the machine trained on the labeled data, it is called a supervised learning. The machine trained on unlabeled data, it is called unsupervised learning. We will discuss later what is unsupervised learning. First, discuss what is supervised learning. Hope you are understood. Yeah. So, this is the one more definition. The supervised learning is a process of providing input data as well as correct output data to the machine learning model. The aim of supervised learning algorithm is to find a mapping function to map the input variable with the output variable Y. This is the what my intention. Yeah, these are the different types of applications like image classification. These are the different types of applications like email classification, fraud detection, spam filtering. Like you know, you are all aware of that some of emails are spam email. How the your domain can separate it already, that is trained. So what your mails are, keep it in your inbox, what the mails are going to the spam folder. So every day you are getting a number of advertisements in your email, but it's not shown in the primary inbox because the machine, your domain is already, the incorporated machine learning technique is already separated. That is called spam, like a fraud detection, like a credit card for fraud identifier, like a email classification. This is the most, nowadays, it is most advanced technology, email classification, like human emotions. Suppose you are in the previously, suppose your CC camera, surveillance camera captured your images. They only captured images, but now the technology is the captured images based on the human emotion, what action he can do, it can predict. Like suppose in a railway station, surveillance camera is there. The surveillance camera taking your pics, maybe capturing. But in the previously only captured. But now the captured images, it can using the machine learning or deep learning methods technology based on the emotions. Suppose you are freely moving smile, your muscles moving different. That is the actual medical scenario. Your artificial smile, the muscle moving is different. Or you are thinking some any illegal activity or maybe any terrorist activity in the next 1 hour or maybe next maybe in the future. So the machine can identify based on the human emotions. That is called many examples like image classification, okay, we'll discuss later. Yeah, this is called what is the supervised learning scenario. Maybe what I'm explained, still anyone have an ambiguity or confused. I hope it will be clear now. See that, this is a simple mathematical example. Mathematicals are all here, the mathematical symbols, everyone aware of it because of from our childhood. So these are the different mathematical symbols. Here the model is trained. The number of symbols like a square, maybe triangle or maybe pentagon, hexagon are here. But the machine has trained on, this is a triangle, this is the square, this is the hexagon. The machine computer is already trained on when the four sides are equal, it is called a square. Maybe three sides, it is called a triangle. Or maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, maybe 5, 6 are there, it is a hexagon. The machine is trained. So this is the trained data. And one more thing, very important point. The machine is always separate the data in the machine learning, two types of terms are very important, trained data and test data. The machine is trying on the trained data. What your data set is given, that is trained. Suppose here, this is all the labeled data, the machine is trained. The machine is trained. After training, one model has to be finalized or maybe one model is generated. Suppose this is the test data. I am giving the tester, actually maybe ikkada manaki visibility undi, it is visible, maybe the computer doesn't know what the symbol is, but the machine is trained on what the square, what the hexagon, what the triangle. So when the tester data is given, so machine is predicted it is a square, it is a triangle. Suppose I am giving circle here, and the tester data is circle here, the machine cannot identify what the symbol is because the machine is not trained on the data. The machine is trained on only hexagon, square and triangle only. So this is the labeled data. So then the machine can predict this is a square, this is a triangle. When I am square, machine is not predicted whether it is a square, whether it is a circle or ellipse. But the machine is, after that, maybe the trained on this one is also. So whatever the data, the 10 from the data set, 100 from the 100%, so the machine is always 70-30%. 70 is the trained data, 30% is the test data. So first training or trained on this data set, 100% data set, then split it on whatever the 30% of test data. The machine is tested on this data set. The previously I have already told you, suppose your accuracy is 95%. So that means your algorithm is good. Your algorithm is good. Suppose your accuracy is maybe 75%, your algorithm is not good. Again trained. Again trained. Simple. The police corp before taking the actual what is called actual position in a particular area, before that the trained, like an army person before the real war. So number of times they trained. Suppose they after trained they are tested. Suppose they are not fit, again trained. Training period increase. So after 6 months, they are tested. Suppose army persons, they are not fit, maybe to fighting like a martial arts. So again training, number of times training. Same as suppose your accuracy is not good, again training on that much data. That is called overfitting, underfitting. We'll discuss later. That is very very important. So once your training testing is good, more than 95% accuracy, so that now any unseen data is given in report, the machine can identify. So that is called what I'm explained, train data and test data. So if the test data is given input, the machine can predict. It is a square, it is a training. One important thing is here, prediction, not what is called in English, you know, the predictor means maybe that is maybe a square, maybe a triangle, not that is what is called conclusion. Not concluded it is a square, it is a triangle, it is predicted. So from your input, like the medical diagnosis, the doctor can predict maybe the tumor is going on your body, or maybe the disease is going in the body, developing in the body. So using some biological terms, maybe like a test reports. The same as the machine can predict, it is a square and it is a triangle. Yeah, the supervisor learning, there are two types, so regression and classification. What the thing is, the classification, so very important thing is, maybe many of the students are getting confusion, regression and classification both the same, not like that. In the classification, it is a categorical data. Regression, it is for a continuous data. Except some logistic regression. Regression is different types, linear regression, multi-regression, linear logistic regression, lasso regression, ridge regression. They are different types of regression techniques, we will discuss later. So is it categorical data? It is a continuous data. Simple, using a classification, I mean previously what the example, suppose weather forecasting, tomorrow what is called temperature, maybe your answer is cloudy, suppose the mission prediction cloudy, or maybe sunny, or maybe raining. It is under classification. Suppose what the tomorrow temperature value, you can, the machine predict the temperature value 48 degrees centigrade or 95 degrees, sorry, 35 degrees centigrade or 48 degrees centigrade using a regression. Simple difference. Or maybe age, like old age people, you can classify the old age, young, you can classify old age people and young age people. That is called under classification. Maybe a old age people 50 to 60, young is or maybe 30 to 40. This is called using a regression, rain, continuous data. Okay. Yeah, supervisor learning techniques are two types, classification defined label, regression no label defined. Okay, next class will continue. So different types of regression techniques, what is a linear regression and what is a multi-regression, discuss with the examples. Okay, thank you.